afternoon, but it's starting to appear like she may have been missing much longer.
When was the last time somebody actually saw this camera?
That's what we're asking. That is what we need to know.
Her parents said they last saw her at 2:30 Saturday morning. According to a search warrant, there was a fire in the backyard 3 hours later.
We gathered some evidence at the fire scene.
The police chief would not elaborate, but the search warrant does. Police found a ransom note on the windshield of a car doused in gasoline. It said, "Mr. Coffey, you like being in control. Now who's in control? We have your daughter, and your pot-smoking redhead son is next, unless you do what is asked. $1 million.
Liz, let me see a picture. There you go, the little girl. This little 10-year-old girl, Zara, has been fighting child bone cancer, has lost part of her left leg, has to wear a prosthetic to walk. And according to neighbors, the stepmother would have her walk long distances, and when the girl could not keep up, she would be punished. She also cannot hear. She lost her hearing in her battle against cancer. And now, just to top it all off, the little girl goes missing. What I don't get, Ellie Jo Stad, is why cops are saying, hey, can anybody say they've seen her in the last month? I thought we were talking about the weekend. What do you mean the last month? Not a neighbor, not anybody at church, not anybody, well, she's homeschooled, the grocery store, nobody?
Right. Well, that's what one of the many disturbing things about this story. She's homeschooled. Her stepmom is homeschooling her, so nobody at school can verify her whereabouts. They also say that they had just moved to this neighborhood, and in fact, they moved around a lot. So none of these neighbors in the neighborhood even knew her. They can't find anybody who's seen her recently.
We're taking your call to Lakeisha, Indiana. Hi, Lakeisha.
Hi, Nancy. It's always nice to talk to you.
Likewise.
I got a comment and a question.
Okay.
I was wanting you to put my family in your prayers. My little girl's father, he's got the Guillain-Barré disease, and he's temporarily paralyzed where he can't use none of his limbs or anything like that.
Lakeisha, what is his name?
Timothy Hart.
I certainly
and
will.
It just break my heart. These cases break my heart also, too. I mean, I don't know how people could just hurt a child. You know, it's
I don't
crazy.
Either. I don't either, Lakeisha. And when I think about what the little girl has already gone through, and look at her in all these pictures, she's smiling.
She's beautiful, yeah.
She's just smiling so big. And what is really crazy, Lakeisha in Indiana, is that the cops are saying, look, forget about this weekend. Has anybody seen her in the last month? They don't even know where to start, Lakeisha in Indiana, because they don't have
crazy.
A timeline. What is your question?
My question was, if the little girl is not found, what kind of charges is this lady gonna face?
Well, first of all, Lakeisha, a murder case can be brought to a jury without a body. And the fact that these dogs are hitting on the family cars, that's a big deal. And remember, this is just how Tot Mom happened. The dogs hitting on the cars. The mother figure here, it's the stepmother being the last one with her. Lie upon lie upon lie. Ellie Jostad, what is the mother being held for tonight, the stepmother?
Yeah, well, right now she is facing a bunch of charges, Nancy. She's written bad checks, driving without a license, also forgery charges, making threats. She's held on over $30,000 bond right now.
Okay, let me see the picture of her with the earring stuck in her eyebrow and the red hair and the black hair. Yeah, I think that's going to be much more of a recent shot if I could. No, I've got another one. You've got another one, Liz. There you go. All right, here she is. This is the most recent picture we've got. Has anybody out there seen this woman with the little girl? This is who we're going to have homeschool our child. Tip line 828-328-5551. If you haven't seen the little girl, have you seen her? And what about this father? He's saying he saw her on Thursday. But now cops cannot confirm her being seen for the last month. Unleash the Lawyers, Ken Hodges, Ann Bremner, Peter Ellican. You know they've got the stepmother behind bars to crack her and make her talk about the little girl. They don't care about a forgery that happened 5 years ago.
No, they don't, but they don't have the evidence to charge her with murder yet, and so they need to develop the evidence, and so they're using this to hold her there, which is a great police investigative technique.
What about it, Peter?
Yeah, I assume that somebody who's doing bad checks and driving without a license and not returning rental property, that doesn't make you a murderer, but it certainly gives them a good reason to hold her for a while, so she can't just be running off, and they've got her where they want her. So it's a standard technique, and they seem to be using it to the max here.
Ann Bremner?
Yeah, what if she doesn't crack, and then what? There's no evidence right now, and there may never be any evidence
John Miller, Ann Bremner's pointing out, saying there's no evidence. But as you're saying, John Miller joining us from the family home there in Hickory, North Carolina, we don't know what all the evidence is yet.
We clearly don't know what all the evidence yet, because as I said for earlier, on Saturday, they told us the dogs did not hit on any of the vehicles or in the home or the crawl space under the home. Today, they said the dogs did hit on two of the vehicles, which had been burned. So there's this drip, drip, drip of information that's coming out,
Probably
because investigators are trying to figure out what's verifiable and what's not. But I think what's going to happen is that we're going to hear that drip, drip, drip over the next several days, and with the community's interest in finding this child and with the help coming from the other investigators, we'll get to the bottom of this relatively
soon. You know what? John, just completely stick with the facts, okay? I know the community's interested.
Oh, please,
all right?
Nancy.
And I know the police are playing it close to the vest. I got it. I want to hear the facts. What can you tell me? Facts only, just the facts, about that ransom note. Where was it found?
Ransom note was found on a vehicle that was burned in the backyard. But that information, again, wasn't told to us until day three of the investigation.
Okay, listen,
that's my
John,
point.
John, I don't care when the information came out. I'm just trying to ascertain the facts.
Oh, you all wasted
right? Let's talk about guys. That. Mark Class, yeah. President, founder, Class Kids Foundation. Ugh. John Miller with the Hickory Daily Records just cleared something up for me. That ransom note. Why would you leave a ransom note sitting out on somebody's car? If you go in to get the little girl, that doesn't make sense.
Well, nothing about a ransom note for a middle-class family makes sense. These are not people that are going to be able to come up with $1 million under any circumstances. And who in the world would want to be burdened with this poor little child who can't walk, who has to depend upon hearing aids? If you're going to steal a child, you're going to steal a healthy child. At least in my estimation, that's what you would do. This is a woman who... Listen, the dogs have hit on human remains. There are possible blood stains. There's no credible sightings of this little girl. There's an apparent history of cruelty towards this little girl by the stepmother. There's a ridiculous ransom note. I think it's really important here for the father to come forth and do whatever he can to clear himself up. That way they can start putting a timeline together. Was she there Thursday? That's very easy to determine, it seems to me. And then they have to start looking for her. They have to start backtracking. And I would suggest, Nancy, that they start looking in any storage lockers that this family might have. Because if they do move around a lot, there's no doubt in my mind that there are probably one or more storage lockers where they hold some of their property.
You know, I want to talk about something you just mentioned, Mark Class. Ellie, what do we know about allegations the stepmother had been cruel to the little girl?
Right, Nancy. Well, apparently neighbors have said that this mother was short-tempered, that she quickly and easily got frustrated with the little girl. And as you mentioned, there are neighbors that are saying she would make the little girl walk long distances on that prosthetic leg, and that she would ground her when she was lagging behind and wasn't keeping up.
I can actually hear more than without my hearing aid.
For a missing 10-year-old girl in North Carolina.
Zara was last seen sleeping in her bed early Saturday morning.
Sleeping in her bedroom around 2 a.m.
An Amber Alert was issued at the time of her disappearance because possible danger